the publication of the proposals here in this meeting that Dr. Tivan Luce and the team will draft. We are really running out of time for this room, so we're going to rush to the conclusion of this event. All the papers here, or all the statements that we'll make here will be published in the Cryer Magazine and the Nation newspaper. The Cryer Magazine has been on the ground for a little while now that we are reviving things, and we do apologize for our little slumber. But we put together a very powerful team that is going to assure you continuity. Not necessarily whether I've been this year or this year or not. There are many people who have taken interest in this activity, and I think they are going to put their integrity on test because they have a powerful team. Before we, I think we have, we don't have any time, but before we conclude anything here, I'll give full time of what the president of the Cryer Foundation was about. Royal Highness Bonanya very, very instrumental to the activities. I cannot tell you how blessed personally I am. I really do exploit him very much, and he allows me to do so. He's been a really powerhouse behind the activities of the Cryer Foundation, and I cannot say how blessed I am. There's never been a day that I've made a suggestion. The fund is always ready to host meetings and to do things. And we are very grateful to have a person like him in our midst. Many other people, they know Boni Chungong. I mean, we were up till 4 o'clock yesterday in Boni's office working on the program for this meeting. And I'm very grateful to have him here, have him as a member of the Cryer Foundation. In his own way, the ambassador is a personal friend. We never agree politically with the ambassador, but I've come to really respect him as a person. And I do, in spite of our political difference, I would never shy away from saying that I do consider him a friend. And if we are moving forward, we do form friendship, some of us through family or whatever. We have differences in politics, but we do really. I've seen the ambassador has come out when we are demonstrating in front of the embassy, and he will stop by and come and shake my hand, and we discuss a little bit, and continue my demonstration. And I think that's the kind of civility we should have. I know I run the risk in my own with my own people of being accused. I'm not afraid of that, of being accused of being what I see, CPDM spy and whatever, but I do go beyond politics to look at inside people. The ambassador's wife, to begin with, I didn't know they were related to our family. He was a very important and very, very resourceful and medical doctor we had. I just learned that was married to the ambassador's wife's sister, and Dr. Ashu, the late Dr. Ashu, who died in Lafayette, the wife was a lady. So, when even we are doing these differences in politics, we should know that even, I used to talk to my friends in Douala that, you know what, when we start the war between La République du Cameroun and Southern Cameroon, the moment when we would, there's a little ceasefire, we'll cross over and drink beer together, and then we'll go back when it's time for war, we start fighting. So let's keep thinking of things in those light, and I think we'll progress better. Even something the heart of the ambassador to tell people to let us go if we want to go without any And let me just say, let the fund say something before the draws out, and I'll just open it for us to dialogue. Is that okay? Let us let the fund say something. It's very quiet. We're living here. The ambassador still wants to say something.
Yes. Okay. Let the phone
say something, and then we'll hand over to
them. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's quite a day from the 6th. Sitting here and expressing ourselves, some people personally and some people to the came in as a citizen, a concerned citizen about anything concerning our country, concerning any part of our country, concerning any individual of our country. As you said, it's not easy to put citizen one, ambassador apart. But if I combine both, I must say that I leave here today very proud. Challenged the Cameroonian community to go beyond political or cultural associations and have an all Cameroonian type of association with all the advantages that you go back to the remarks I made, the remarks I made that day. I tried to lead it. So I'm glad to hear that that call. Talking of Northwest and Southwest, where as people or as provinces, we know of the difficulties we had within the boundaries. We're not the last. We know the Arab Shoah and the others with lots of land. We could go region by region, province by province, and find the same type of situation that we are addressing here, bothering, hindering progress of our survival. This type of initiative, you are creating a pattern that ought to be intensified, extended, so that as we talk our problems, whether they are real or not, but they are always real because they are in some people's mind. We tend at least to see that they do not exist, when they do not exist, and when they exist, we address them to resolve. So for this, I really need to commend you, and that's why I said that I'm leading as a very proud ambassador. We have lived Cameroon. They don't get rid of Mars, the positive, the creative thinking. This is an enriching experience. And I encourage you to continue to pursue this particular topic and extend it to many others. Politicians will always be on the picture, good ones and bad ones, trying to use our differences or those that may be trying to create. We have to discipline them. I'm one of those who believe that even Cameroonian politicians, people discipline them more and more. So, in essence, idea that there would be no more stuff in what you are doing so well. I noticed something that I take away that I would. Are there problems between the North and the Southwest, or any of the other parties of our country that I have mentioned here? Something that I take. I have not heard that one part or one people has made it so that the other part is being denied education, is being denied health care. If a Northwesterner goes to a Southwest doctor, I haven't heard that he would say, because you're in the Northwest, I will not take care of you. Don't do anything with that. I've not heard that children from Northwest or Southwest or any other part of Cameroon are, by our politics or by law, being denied the education that will make sure that the real Cameroon that we envision. And my daughter surprised me here today by the language she was taking, she was using. Keep your problems with you. Let the young generation, the Cameroon of tomorrow, be one. And that is what it takes tonight. So thank you. I commend you again. And for all of us, whatever we do, let's do it to make sure that long live Cameroon.
Thank you, Mr. Ambassador. I do accept the praises that you know it goes for the entire team, because I would be lying if I said that it's only alone. We have a strong team, and we're going to work. The thing that I know I've done is that I was able to win the interest of most of these members and brought them together. And we are a team that we are going to do more. And I think most of us from the speeches we heard here are really bent on seeing that we solve our problems. Even if there are no problems, we are bent to see that we stand strong as united people. So the panelists and everybody, even Charlie, I know you're going back to Ohio, we would be meeting Dr. Robinson to tell us when it's convenient to make a final draft of putting together everything that we have resolved here in one package, because many people, not only here in America, back home, interest to learn from what we have decided here, so we need to bring it all together because it's so well in our peace. So, yes, Mr.
I know it's often hard to talk constructively, especially after the phone and the ambassador have spoken, but my conceptual belief is that when we Cameroonians disagree, we do so to agree. When we patch meets. I also have another philosophy which makes me believe that Cameroon, our fatherland, represents an ideal democratic concept yet unpracticed in Africa. And we as Anglophones, as a people, we should in fact sometimes look inward into ourselves and ask ourselves whether the littoral and the south and the other provinces can themselves seem to say they want to have a dialogue. Having said that, I believe that Cameroon, like the United States, constitutes a democratic concept yet unpracticed in Africa. In fact, inwardly I believe that, like the principles of government and politics here, where people are made up of different cultures, different backgrounds, different languages, what must be the guiding principle among those people must be a federal system. The problems between Southwest and Northwest stem from the fact that we are all in this one melting pot of a unitary system, where everybody leaves Bamenda to go to Yaoundé to give bribe and comes back. By the time you get back, your money is finished. You leave Victoria, you go to Yaoundé, you struggle, you don't know French, you give bribe. By the time you come back, your money is finished. My conceptual view is that we in the United States can forge ahead and tell our country that our unity system has outlived its usefulness, and that we should strive for another system. One of my disagreements with my friend from Northwest is that he told me, Monana, you started the Southern Cameroon movement here. Why then are you in the CPBM? That is the disagreement I have with some of my colleagues from the Northwest, because they believe that if you are in SCNC, you must only be in SDN. That is conceptually wrong. That is why I think when we disagree, we must do so to agree. Let us forge a system. Let the CREA Foundation find an alternative, a way through which we can move forward and urge our country to look into the principles of federalism. Because federalism brings government closer to its people. It makes for competition between rival provinces and states. It is a better system for us. Mr. Cryer Foundation, would you please look for an alternative to make us discuss a federal system that we in America can give to our country and say, look, this is the alternative, whereby if there are 10 provinces or 10 states, if somebody wins 6, 7, he or she can become the president. That gives us a leverage whereby each and every one of us here can believe we can one day aspire to be president of our own country.
Thank you very much, Mr. Can is there anybody who can lead us in a closing prayer, very brief prayer?
Please, let us pray.
Can you read the prayer? The prayer we have from the
I don't have my glasses. So I can pray without reading.
Okay, lead us with your prayer.
I don't have my glasses. So let's pray. Most gracious and everlasting Father, we thy children come before thee from our beloved nation Cameroon, our fatherland, a land of opportunity, a land of glory, a land devoted, a land divine. We beseech thee, O Lord, to guide us, to be gentle, loving, peaceful as ever, enduring as ever, friendly as we've always been, and to know that in one canopy we stand, our destiny in our hands before you, and that you will lead the way. And to all of us who believe in thee as thy own personal Savior, O Lord, will you say amen?
Yes. Amen.
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 Okay, many thanks to Dr. Leanne for coming all the way for help us moderation. So we have your comment.
Inspire you a little bit.